It's AumSum time.
Hi guys, can you guess the title of my next video? Hurry up! Write your guess in the comment section below.
What is arthritis?
It is a chemical formed by mixing hydrochloric acid and sulfuric acid.
Oh, dude. From where do you get such ideas? To explain arthritis, we need to first understand what a joint is. A joint is a place where two bones meet. When there is inflammation, swelling, or pain in one or more joints, then it is termed as arthritis. The cause of arthritis depends upon the type of arthritis. Rheumatoid arthritis is an autoimmune disorder. In this disorder, our immune cells mistakenly start attacking the tissue surrounding a joint and thus damage it. This leads to inflammation, swelling, and pain in the joint. Osteoarthritis occurs when the cartilage that cushions the ends of bones in a joint gradually breaks down and wears away. As a result, the bones begin to rub against each other, causing swelling and pain in that joint. Why does our stomach growl?
'Cause there are bears in our stomach!
Nah. Growling sound is produced mostly due to movement of gas in the digestive tract, especially in the intestines. Now, gas can either enter or be produced in the intestines.
But how?
When we eat food very quickly, sometimes we swallow gas such as air along with food. Besides this, bacteria in our intestines also produce gases. Now, during digestion, the muscles of our intestines contract in order to push food ahead. However, gases also get pushed along with food. Now, as our intestines are hollow tubes, such movement of gases produces growling sounds. Besides this, hunger increases growling. This is because when we are hungry, our digestive system starts preparing for the next meal. Hence, it clears the remains of last meal, causing more muscle contraction, thus producing more growling sounds.
Why do we get angry when we are hungry?
Due to hunger, when people get grumpy and angry, then they are said to be hangry. Hunger-induced anger is believed to be caused due to various reasons.
Dude, tell me fast, I'm feeling hungry.
Alright. When we eat food, it is mostly converted to glucose. This glucose is absorbed by blood and then transported to our cells, especially those present in our brain. However, when glucose level drops, our brain perceives it as a life-threatening situation. It gets stressed, thus making us impatient and irritated, which eventually leads to anger. In addition to this, when our energy levels are low, a brain chemical called neuropeptide Y is produced that makes us hungry and encourages us to eat. But as the same chemical regulates aggression, its production makes us angry as well, thus making us hangry. Topic: motion sickness. Why do we get car sickness?
Because some cars are haunted.
Nah. According to a prevailing theory, car sickness occurs because of mismatched or conflicting sensory signals. In a moving car, our eyes see that the car seats are not moving, thus informing our brain that we are stationary. However, the inner ear, which detects motion, notices the turns and bumps in the road and tells our brain that we are moving, thus creating a sensory mismatch and making us car sick.
But why do we vomit?
During human evolution, when there were no vehicles, only the intake of foods containing neurotoxins made our brain receive conflicting signals. Now, the only way to remove these neurotoxins was to vomit. Hence, in the present time, when our brain receives such mismatched signals, it thinks that there is some neurotoxin in our stomach. Thus, it induces vomiting. Topic: osmosis. How do fish drink water?
That's easy. Using a straw.
No. Fish take in water usually through their mouth or gills, depending on whether they live in fresh water or salt water. Freshwater fish takes in water mainly through its gills.
But why?
Because it has less water and more salt concentration in its blood than the surrounding water, Hence, due to osmosis, water from the surrounding flows through the gills into its bloodstream. However, as the fish is continuously taking in water, it urinates a lot and removes excess water. Saltwater fish takes in water through its mouth.
Oh, really?
This is because its blood has more water and less salt concentration than the salt water around it. Hence, to maintain the balance, the fish gulps salt water through its mouth, filters the water for its use, and expels excess salt while urinating.